Hi everyone, welcome to Dataverse Academy. In today's video, we will learn end-to-end use of data warehouse. First, we will create a data warehouse. Then, we will load the data to the data warehouse using data pipeline. And then, we will transform it using T-SQL procedure. And at last, we'll create a Power BI report. Now, let's create data warehouse in Microsoft Fabric. Login to your Microsoft Fabric account, then click on Microsoft Fabric, then click on your data warehouse, then click on workspaces. Here click on your workspace, then click on new and choose data warehouse, click on it. Then provide the name for your data warehouse. Then click on create. Our data warehouse is created successfully. So here you can see we have schemas and then we have security folder. So you can create your schema. Then under that you can create your tables, procedures, functions, triggers, all other entities. And if you assign some roles to the different users, those will come under the security. Now we will learn how we can load the data into data warehouse using data pipeline. For that, click on get data. Then click on new data pipeline. Provide name to your data pipeline. Then click on create. This window will come up here. Using this, you can copy the data from one location to another location. But I'm not going to use this. Let me cancel this. Now we will use the copy activity to load the data from Azure Blob Storage to our data warehouse. So Microsoft has provided some sample data repository from which we will choose the worldwide importers data. There we have different dimensions and fact data. So we will load dimension customer data to our data warehouse. Click on add pipeline activity, then choose copy data. Give name to your copy data activity. Provide description. As we are loading the data of worldwide importers from Blob Storage to data warehouse, so we will provide the description accordingly. Then you can provide the timeout value according to yourself. So I'll choose 1 hour. And if you want to retry after failure, then you can provide the value. I'll retry it for 2 times. And click on advance. Here you can provide the retry interval. Retry interval, I'll choose 30 seconds only. If you check both secure output and secure input, it means your input and output data information will not be stored in the log file. I'll put it as unchecked. Now click on source. Here, as you know, we are going to read the data from Azure Blob Storage. Then choose external. Then we need to create a connection to that Azure Blob Storage. So for that, click on new. Now click on Azure Blob Storage. Then click on continue. Here we need to provide the URL, which is provided by the Microsoft. This is the URL which is provided by the Microsoft. Now let me give the name to my connection. Now let's click on create. Our connection is successfully created. Let me test it. Click on test connection. Perfect, it is working fine. Now we need to provide the file path for worldwide importers data, which is stored in one of the container under which we have different folders. We also need to provide the directory name in which dimension customer file is stored. File path is sample data. Directory name is worldwide importers / tables. Under this directory, we have different fact tables and dimension table. So we need to read the dimension customer file only. Our file name is dimensioncustomer.parquet. Choose file format as Parquet. Then click on destination. As we know, we are going to load the data into our data warehouse. Then choose workspace. Then choose data warehouse. Then provide your data warehouse name. This is my data warehouse which I have created earlier. Click on it. Then click on auto create. And provide your schema name and table name. So we are going to load the data into our DBU schema. So we'll provide DBUSR schema. Then provide table name. Our table name will be dimension underscore customer. I have choose auto create table because we haven't created the table in our data warehouse. So what will happen when we will run this flow, that table will be created under DBU schema. Now save your pipeline. Our pipeline is successfully saved. Now let's run it. Click on run. It will take few minutes to complete it. Our pipeline ran successfully. Let's check the details. You can see we have read one file, and in that file we have 403 rows which are loaded into our dimension customer table into the data warehouse. Let's check the table into our data warehouse. Click on your workspace, then click on your data warehouse. You can see our dimension customer file is loaded successfully. And you can see the data in the data view. If you want to read the data from this table using SQL query, for that you need to click on new SQL query, then click on new SQL query. Write select star from dbu.dimensionCustomer. And we'll read only top 10 rows. Then run it. You can see we got the output. Now we will learn how we can load the data into data warehouse using copy into command. Now we will create the tables into our data warehouse. Then we will load the tables from Azure Blob Storage using copy into command. Microsoft has provided some sample data repository. So from that, we will use worldwide importers data under which we have different dimensions and fact tables from which we will load dimension city and fact sale file. Let's first create tables into our data warehouse. So for that, click on new SQL query. To save our time, I have already created the create table script. Let me paste it. Here, first we are dropping the table if it already exists. And then we are creating the dimension city tables. So these are the columns which we have in our dimension city table. City key, ID, city, state, country, and other columns. For the fact sale table, first we are dropping it if it already exists. then we are creating the table into a data warehouse. So in this table, we have foreign keys from our dimension tables and some measure values. What I'll do, I'll paste these table scripts into the description so that you can use for your purpose. Let me run it. Our tables are created successfully. Here you can see we have dimension city and facsimile table. Now let's rename our SQL query. Click on it, then click on rename. Provide significant name to your query, then click on rename. Now we will load the data into this table. Click on new query. To save our time, I have already created the query. Let me paste it. Here I'm using copy into command. So first write copy into, then your data warehouse table name, then from keyword, and we need to provide the location from which we will read the file. This is the Azure sample data location from which I will read the dimension city file. Then with keyword, and what is our file type? Our file type is Parquet. So I have put file type equal to Parquet. If suppose you are reading the data from CSV, then you need to provide it as CSV. Same I did for my facsimile table. Copy into table name, from, then sample data location, with, and file type equal to Parquet. Let me run it. It will take few minutes to load it. Let's wait for it. Our query is executed successfully. Let's check the data. Click on dimension city table. You can see data is loaded successfully. Click on facsimile table. In facsimile also, our data is loaded successfully. If you want to check the data using SQL query, what you can do? Click on it, then click on new SQL query, then click on select top 100 rows. It will give you the top 100 rows from facsimile table. Same way, you can fetch the data from other tables as well. Now we will learn how we can write a query in data warehouse. We will create a query using Visual Query Builder. We will calculate total profit and total tax per day by state and city. So for total profit and total tax, we need facsimile table. And for state and city, we need dimension city table. Click on new visual query. Then drag facsimile table into the editor. Then drag dimension city table into the editor. Now we will join both the tables based on common column. So let's find out which is the common column between facsimile and dimension city. So you can see we have city key in facsimile and city key in dimension city. So we will join based on city key column. Before merging it, we will filter facsimile table and we will take only top 100 rows because we have huge amount of data in facsimile table and it's gonna take lot of time for combining both the tables. To filter the rows, what you need to do, click on reduce rows, keep top rows and provide number of rows, then click on OK. It will show you only top 100 rows. Now we will join both the tables based on city key. Click on combine, then click on merge queries. We will take Faxil table as left table and dimension city as right table. We will join based on city key. Then we will use inner join. Click on OK. After combining both the tables, you need to choose required column from dimension city table. For that, click on it, then choose state and city. Then click on OK. Now, as you know, we need to show the total tax, total profit per day by state and city. Then we need to do the group by based on invoice date key, city and state provinces. For that, click on transform data, click on group by. Now we will click on advanced, because in basic you can only do the group by based on single column, but we need to do a group by based on city, state and invoice key. As we need total profit and total tax, so for that we need to do the sum of profit and sum of tax. Total profit, sum of profit. Then click on add aggregation. Then total tax, sum, column name will be tax. Then click on OK. You can see we got the output: profit, total tax per day by state and city. Now we will learn how we can transform and load the data into data warehouse using T-SQL procedure. So for that, click on new SQL query. To save our time, I have already designed the T-SQL procedure. Let me paste it. In our procedure, we will write a query to get total profit and total tax per day by state and city. So for that, click on new SQL query. To save our time, I have already designed my T-SQL procedure. Let me paste it. Here, first I'm dropping the procedure if it already exists. Then I'm creating my procedure. Then I'm creating the target table for storing my result. In this table, I have columns date, city, state, tax amount and profit. Then I'm writing my SQL query to calculate total tax and total profit per day by state and city. So for that, I'm joining Faxil table and dimension city table based on city key. From Faxil, I'm taking profit and tax amount. And from dimension city, I'm taking state and city. And I'm doing the group by based on invoice date key, city and state provinces. Then I'm sorting the data based on date key, state and city. And then I'm storing the output of my query into this table. This is the table which I have created above. Now let me run it. Our procedure is created successfully. Let me verify it. Click on schemas, then click on refresh. Our procedure is created under stored procedure folder. Click on it. You can see our procedure here.
Now let's run it. For that, click on New SQL Query. Then type exe and your procedure name. And select it and run. Our procedure ran successfully. Let's check if our table is created or not. You can see our table is created successfully. Let's check the data from this table. For that, write select top 10 star from table name. Now select it and run. You can see we got the result. Here we have total tax, total profit per day by state and city. Now we will learn how we can create a data set and then we will create Power BI dashboard using that data set. Now we will create a data set using fact sale and Dimensionality table. Then we will create a Power BI dashboard using that data set. For that, click on Model. Here you can see we have all the tables which are lying in our data warehouse. Then we have default data set which is automatically get created. We are not going to use the default data set. We will create our separate data set. To create a data set, click on Reporting, then click on New Power BI data set. We will choose Fact Sale and Dimensionality table. Then click on Confirm. You will be moved to the new window. Here you can see a data set is created successfully. Now we need to create the relationship between Fact Sale and Dimensionality table. So we have city key in both the tables. Click on city key, then map it with city key column of Fact Sale table. Then click on confirm. As you can see, relationship is created successfully. Let's rename our data set. Click on it. Provide significant name. Now we will create Power BI report using this data set. Click on new report. You will be moved to the new window. As you can see, we have Dimensionality and Fact Sale table. First, we will create profit by sales territory. For that, I'll use clustered column chart. Click on it and pick sales territory from Dimensionality and move it to x-axis. Then we need to pick the profit from Fact Sale table. Move it to y-axis. You can see sum of profit by sales territory. Now we will show profit by state provinces. For that, I'll use Azure map. Click on it, pick state provinces and move it to location. Now we will select profit from Fact Sale table and move it to size. Here you can see sum of profit by state provinces. Now we will show total profit, total tax per day by state and city using table. Pick table. Then select invoice date key from Fact Sale table, city from Dimensionality, state provinces from Dimensionality, then profit from Fact Sale and tax amount from Fact Sale. Here you can see we got total profit, total tax per day by state and city. Let's save our report. Click on File, click on Save. Provide name to your report. Then click on Save. Our report is saved successfully in our workspace. let me close this window and as well as dataset window. Now, if you want to see your dataset and report, then click on your workspace. Here you can see a dataset and a report. If you want to change anything in your dataset, click on it, then click on open data model. Now you can change in your dataset. Let me close it. And if you want to change anything in your report, click on it. Then click on edit. Now you can do the required changes. That's it in this video.